Hello everyone and welcome to Prodigal Overland. I am so glad you're here. I hope you're doing well. This episode is us going to Silver Lake Sand Dunes with our good friends and having a great time. Now, I already filmed an intro the day we went. Let me drop a little bit of that in here. Today we are going to be heading to Silver Lake Sand Dunes in Michigan. The whole family is coming. And so we've got two in our crew. I'll let you be the ones to kind of guess that are a little anxious about today because there's supposed to be this big hill that's called Test Hill, I guess, in the beginning. That's really steep that you have to get up and over to even get in and do anything in the park. So we're going to try that, obviously, first. I have a little bet going with Jeff on whether or not I can make it up the first time or not. He's confident that I won't be able to. I've got a bug crawling on me. Now here's the thing about filming the intro before you've actually gone is other than where we go, I can't really tell you what's gonna happen. So I decided, why do that? I would much rather film the intro after we've done everything. So I can tell you in this video that you're gonna see a lot of sand, couple breakdown slash vehicle destructions, and just a lot of fun. So I hope you guys enjoy this video, and without further ado, here it is.
Are you filming me?
Yeah.
Yeah?
The lap.
Ready, set, go.
Well, it's still clipped here in the middle. We can get it back up.
Okay.
Test Hill is behind me. That's Test Hill. That's the hill. I gotta make it up to get free food tonight. It was 50 bucks, but then Jeff wanted to let me out because it's such an intimidating hill. So now we did dinner. Just dinner. First thing we said when we pulled up was, oh, it's not as steep this year. I think these guys just need to get out of their state a little more. I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't look too bad, but we'll see. If I don't make it up and I trash talk it now, Jeff's gonna be on me all day. But it doesn't seem too bad right now. So, anyway, we're about to do it. All right, dude.
There they go.
There they go. All right, Jeff made it up the hill first time. He's got just regular tires on his ride. Regular all-weather flat tires. So we'll see. I'm down to about 17 PSI, so we'll give it a try.
Everybody give a thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Thumbs up. This one's for you, Jeff.
Woo! I'm pretty sure it's puppy. Woo!
was telling you about the peak.
Yeah, I heard a lot of junk from you, honestly. A lot of crap. This one too. What did you say? This one's been trash talking machine.
You almost didn't make it.
No, I had to slow down. Yeah. I'm like, come on.
Once you slowed down, it was like,
no, no. Everything under control. Hey, Nora, come here. Come here. Come here.
That side by side looks cool.
Mr. Jeff said that you would lose your stuff coming up that you'd be a mess.
It was actually fun.
It was fun.
There you go.
That side by side looks cool.
Looks like, and the great news is we get a great dinner tonight. Compliments.
All right, so we stopped for lunch. Also let a little more air out of the tire at Jeff's insistence. I was aired down about 17 when we started and definitely got kind of bogged down in some spots. Not stuck, and you know, I could reverse out of it, but he's rolling around 10. So I've never gone lower than about 18, 19. So I did let some more out, so we're around 13. So we'll see if that makes a difference. But let me just show you the difference in tire tread with the different pressures. So this is my tires, and you can see that so far I've not even kind of accessed any of the sidewall tread here. So let me show you Jeff's tires. So here's Jeff, and as you can see, he's got sand all around his sidewall, so he's definitely rolling on his sidewall, which is going to give him a bigger footprint than I have. So I did go down some. He's at 10. I'm slowly getting the nerve to work down lower and lower. I guess a little fear of popping my beadlock, but hopefully that doesn't happen, says it won't, so we'll see. After we spent the morning kind of driving around, it was time to check in with my crew to see how they were feeling about this whole experience. We had definitely some nerves with the ladies before we went out on this trip. Some of them are not exactly thrill seekers, so there was a little anxiety leading up to this. But as you'll see, I think they did a great job.
So far, less scarier than I expected.
Yeah.
I had a little bit of anxiety leading up to this. There was so much talk about Test Hill and how scary it was.
A lot of hype on this, wasn't there?
There was. So I had myself kind of really geared up for nothing.
Yeah, wasn't bad at all, huh?
So now I'm enjoying myself. Couldn't ask for a better day. I mean, look at this crystal clear water. That ain't no Jersey Shore.
Okay, you can clear.
What do you think so far, Tristy?
Of this?
Yeah, of the off-roading. I know you don't like off-roading, but as far as off-roading goes, where would this rank on your likes and dislikes?
Well, it's better than most, mainly because
so you don't have to worry about going off a cliff, so that's better, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, well, sort of fun. Yeah.
You do like the bumps a little bit. Yeah, did we get stuck at all? Did we get hung up in the sand some?
Yeah.
Just a little bit, right? Not really stuck, we just got halted by the sand and had to reverse a little, right?
Yeah, but stuck.
What's your favorite part?
Is when it gets one of those, like, you think you're going down, you're gonna crash, but you go like up.
Yeah. How is this rank on your list of off-roading? Like, is this your favorite or?
I'm rated 5 stars.
5 stars, okay.
Out of 10.
So one of the things that we were kind of anxious about, in addition to the Test Hill, was, and Jeff kept talking about this pit that he had been in, this circle of doom, he called it, where he was spinning around in his car and almost rolled the thing, flipped it right over because of the depth of this hole. So, mind you, I have in my brain something equivalent to maybe some of the holes we saw out in Moab, where it is legitimately steep. So we rolled up on this area after lunch. He wanted to take us to show us these pits of doom. And so we rolled up and saw several small circles in the ground. And everybody in the car, in my car at least, was like, for real? Like, this is what he was talking about? The funny thing was, it was actually in this area where things started to go kind of off kilter here. As you'll see here in just a minute, for some reason, this is where Jeff lost one of the beads on his tire, and it was the craziest thing because he'd kind of done a circle kind of just as we were pulling up and went around, and I was like, for real, this is it. And then we kind of pulled off to the area, and I was pulling the drone out because I wanted to get some shots. And when Jeff started to get going again, there was this loud thump, 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 thump in one of his tires, and we looked, and sure enough, he had completely lost the bead lock. It was a great learning experience for me, though, because Jeff was able to figure out how to get this thing back on. And using this ratcheting strap to put pressure in the center of the tire, to kind of force the outsides of the tires back out, and then use the pump to kind of fill things up. And with a little kicking and hitting and punching, he was eventually able to get this tire seated back on the rim properly.
Shooting, are we live?
Yeah.
Because I would just like to say one thing. Not by design, but it seems like Jeff's vehicle is always the vehicle that's having issues. When we were in the UP, I was pulling him out of mud.
Well, yeah.
Now we're at the sand dunes and his tire went. He's using my recovery board, my pump, my battery, and my ratchet strap, and his wisdom. I'll give you that. His wisdom. Try to get this out, but it's always, doesn't matter what he's driving, it doesn't seem like. This is a Land Cruiser. Still, we have issues. I don't know what's going on. I really don't.
Maybe it's just bad luck.
So once I got out of the Jeep, I was able to look and see my rear bumper hanging. We pulled out some duct tape and were able to kind of massage it back into place. And I hadn't yet actually got myself going up the dune on video. So we pulled out the drone. I figured I'm probably going to knock this bumper off again, but heck, it's already halfway there. So we went ahead and did it again and made it.
Tape just rips because right. It acts like a shovel, so yeah. All the sand is.
So you rip the back bumper off. Well, it's still clipped here in the middle.
Oh, well.
We can get it back up and then just be done with it.
We're going home after this.
You hit it that time, man. It
just went. Popped out.
Popped right out.
All right, guys, with a bumper that's ripped off, we duct taped it back on. We think we're gonna call it a day from there. When we get back home, I gotta figure out how to fix that rear bumper. Lots of fun out here at the sand dunes. We had a great time. I hope you liked the video. Give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. We'll see you again real soon. We're about to get out to Michigan next, or out of Michigan into Indiana next. So again, thanks for watching.